everyone. Now my next video is how to find out the rate of interest and the number of installment when maturity value interest is given to you. Suppose if the question is Rishi has a RD account in a bank. He deposited rupees 200 per month for a period of 3 years. If at the time of maturity is given to you, this is very important, maturity, he gets rupees 8,088. Find the rate of interest. Now this is the question. What is given to you? You write it first. Principal is given to you, rupees 200. Time is 3 years. It means the number of installment will be 3 into 12, 36. And maturity value is given to you, rupees 8,088. Now, here in the question, it's given maturity value is rupees itna. That's why I have written maturity value as this one. Now, write the formula for the maturity value first of all. You know the formula is NP plus I. Substitute the value in this one. It's 8,088 is equals to N is 36, P is 200 plus I. First, we will take out the interest and then we will take out the rate. So, it will be 8,088. Is equals to 0,7200 plus I. So the interest will be 8,088 minus 7,200. So it will be 8,8 subtract this one and then n minus 2 is 8. So 888 is the I coming. So the interest is 888. Now as yesterday I told you that I is P into N, N plus 1 into R upon 2 into 12 into 100. Now put the value there. It is coming 888, P is 200, N is 36, 36 plus 1 into rate. Rate we have to find out. So write it as R upon 2 into 12 into 100. Is it okay? Now simplify it. These two zeros will get cancelled from these two zeros. 12, 3s are 36. Now the remaining term is 2 into 3 into 37 into R upon 2. Now what we can do? This 2 will also get cancelled. Now the return percent is 888. Upon 3 into 37. Now simplify this one. It will be 21 to 9, 11. So this will get cancelled. So 8. So the R is coming 8%. So in this way, we will take out the rate. Now suppose if the question is twisted, if they will write that as a interest. It means the interest is given to you and then again the same way we have to apply the formula and then cross multiply, we will get the rate. Now in the same way, now I will explain you how to find out the number of installment. Now number of installment means this is the fourth type of a question in which we will take out the number of installment. Now suppose if the question is, we will write what is given to you and then how to find out the number of installments. Now suppose the principal is given to you, interest is given to you, and now look at here. Suppose Sonali deposit, this is the example number 4, principal is given to you rupees 240 per month and rate of interest is 10%. And at the time of maturity, he gets 4,662. This is the amount which he gets after. And then we have to find out the number of installment. What is the number of installment here? Now what we will do? We will write the formula first. That is maturity value is equals to NP plus I. And as we know, the formula for the I is P into N. plus 1 into r upon 2 into 12 into 100. Now this is the formula. Substitute the values, all the values in this one now. Maturity value is 4662. Number of installment we don't know. N. P is 240 here. Then 240 into N. N plus 1. R is 10 upon 2 into 12 into 100. Now what we will do? We will simplify this term and then take out the LCM. Let's simplify this one first. This 0 will get cancelled from this one 0. Again 1 0 will get cancelled from this one. 12, 2s are 24, this 2 will get cancelled. So the remaining term is now 4660 to 240n plus n, n plus 1 upon, no term is remaining here now. Now this is 240n plus n square plus n. Now this become a quartic equation here now. So what we will write, n square plus n, n plus 241 is 241n. It is 241n minus 4662 equals to 0. Now this become a quartic equation. And quartic equation split in the middle term, we know how to solve it. We will make the factors of 4662. It's 2331. Then again, by which number we can solve this one? It's 3. It will be 777. Then again, we will solve it by the 3. It's 259. Now, it's a prime number. We cannot solve it. Now, the term will be n square plus 259n minus 18n. Rest of the term will be as it is. Now, n common, n plus 259. 18 common, n plus 259 equals to 0. So, one bracket, it's n minus 18 and n plus 259 equals to 0. So, the value of n is coming 18. It means the number of installment is 18. We will convert into years now. 18 by 12, it's 3. 6 threes are 18, 6 twos are 12. 1 whole, 1 by 2 years. One whole, 1 by 2 years. So children, it's clear to all of you how to find out the number of installments and the rate of interest. Now, you will solve the exercise which is given in your chapter number 2, 2A you will solve. If any query you have, let me know about your queries. I will take your queries in the next video. Thank you.